If you thought the pain of broken heart was strictly an emotional response, then you need to think again. In medical field, a broken heart is not just a folklore anymore. Alright, so what is broken heart syndrome? A study examines 19 patients who suffered cardiac problems following sudden emotional stress. This study thus offers a possible explanation. A broken heart syndrome is a temporary heart condition wherein the heart muscles become acutely weak. The heartstrings can break, causing heart to lose form and as a result be unable to pump blood effectively. Yes, you can literally die from a broken heart now. This syndrome is also known as stress cardiomyopathy, Takotsubo cardiomyopathy or apical ballooning syndrome. Let's see what exactly happens in the broken heart syndrome. Well, we still don't understand the exact mechanism of this type of acute heart failure, but the evidence finds a strong interplay between the brain and the heart. Hours of extreme emotional trauma can cause transient stunning of the left ventricle, as we know that the left ventricle is the one that pumps out blood to the rest of the body. As a result, our heart becomes partially frozen, causing poor circulation or even shock or death in more extreme cases. Risk factors. This syndrome usually affects women more than men, particularly Asian postmenopausal women. Age. It appears that most people who have broken heart syndrome are older than 50. A current psychiatric disorder. If you have had disorders such as anxiety or depression, you probably have higher risk of stress cardiomyopathy. Is it possible that you're walking around with a broken heart syndrome and you don't even know it? Yes, it is possible. Let's have a look at some of the most common symptoms of this syndrome, which includes chest pain, shortness of breath, irregular beating of heart, fainting, and low blood pressure. If you are a person having long-lasting chest pain or any of these symptoms, then it's important to take it seriously, call 911 and get examined by your doctor immediately. What's fascinating is that the stress-induced cardiomyopathy, despite its serious presentation, is usually reversible and most patients recover with no long-term heart damage. The syndrome can sometimes happen again, though most of the people won't experience a second event. Once the diagnosis is made, the patient is treated with ACE inhibitors to lower the blood pressure, beta blockers to slow down the heart rate, diuretics to decrease the fluid buildup, and anti-anxiety medicines to manage stress. They also recommend aspirin to patients who also have atherosclerosis. Most of the abnormalities in systolic function and ventricle wall movement clear up in 1 to 4 weeks, and most patients recover fully within 2 months and the heart failure in about 20% of the patients. Hence, it is important to recognize and manage stress in your life, which will help in preventing the syndrome, though there is currently no evidence to prove it. I hope you liked this video and do comment on what you would like to see next. Please subscribe and catch me up in the next video.